Sarah on Arrow before we see Legends beginning?
Am I allowed to say? I can say that you will see me on Arrow. I will definitely be doing episodes on Arrow. And, I mean, it would make sense for me to come kind of back to life. But I don't know. We'll see. But I'll definitely be making appearances on the show, for sure. And the big part of the first half of both Arrow and Flash of the seasons will be setting our show up, setting our characters up, and getting things into place so that when we dive into it, it's like we're there, we're going.
So how does White Canary differ from the Canary we've already seen?
Well, I don't know yet.
Okay.
But from, I'm like, it's so funny because we like come out here and then we just get little tidbits of information from the producers, and I'm hearing very exciting things. But, you know, the person who goes into the pit is not necessarily the same person who comes out. And there's going to be ramifications of that. And I'm hoping that she's, like, going to be, like, a little crazy and kind of have to find herself again. And we already know she was a little crazy to begin with, so this might be, like, super off the rocker, which I'd be into.
We're going to see her conferring perhaps with Thea about, because Thea's another person that's gone through the pit, and see kind of what, I don't know, they're just comparing notes on what the side effects might be.
I'm actually looking forward to that because I never really got to do anything with Thea on Arrow before, and I think because of that, I can't imagine us not having some good scenes together, and, you know, talking about that or having those shared experience, so definitely I think there'll be some kind of connection.
Well, Sarah also, I mean, Thea was responsible for her death, so, I mean, they have a lot to talk about.
Yeah, but it wasn't her fault. You know, we'll see. If Sarah learns that it's not the Merlin, like, I imagine, out for blood. But maybe she'd still be mad at Thea. I don't know, it's a hard image to shake, I guess, if that whoever shot you in the chest with 3 arrows.
Is Nyssa a character you would like to see on Legends of Tomorrow?
For sure. Yeah. Katrina Law, who plays Nyssa, and I are good friends now. I would love to keep working with her. And it's just such an interesting relationship. I thought the writers did great creating that dynamic. So I definitely like to see more of that. And I'd like to see more of that in the flashbacks. If we have flashbacks on the show, it'd be a cool thing to explore.
Just going to be like an action series? I mean, or is there going to be like actual stories with these characters outside of just them fighting whatever the big robot of the week or whatever it is?
I mean, the whole series depends on the relationships of these characters. It is that epic. The whole thing is set up to serve one storyline. So rather than like a bad, you know, bad guy of the week, it's like we're very much serving a more serialized storyline. Within that, none of that stuff will work unless you have those relationships with the characters. And I think just the different dynamics that will happen is going to have a lot of that. And, you know, just imagining how much you could do just Sarah alone and, like, with her dad and her sister and the family. And it's so interesting to me. I'm like, is this just going to turn into, like, one giant show that we're on 3 nights a week, you know? Because I want it to. I want it to be all these different crossovers and stuff like that. But no, it's definitely not just action, blow everything up, though that will be a fun part of it. But there'll be some great storylines, just like there was for Sarah on Arrow. I can't imagine that disappearing.
Have you been given any indication yet how this group is going to come together and what will bring them together?
I think that the pilot will be about, we get to see that, but it is Rip Hunter, who is this rogue time traveling British guy, played by Arthur Darvill, who is unfortunately not here, but he's the one who kind of brings us together for the greater good. There's something, you know, he's time traveling and he knows that he needs to bring us together to make that thing happen. So,
so it's not going to be several episodes to build into it. It's something that's going to happen pretty quickly.
Yeah, what it sounds like is we're getting like kind of an Ocean's 11, kind of come get the group together and let's roll.
Sarah has had multiple lives in some way. She keeps coming back. And Hawkgirl has been reincarnated a couple times. Will the two characters interact and bond over that, perhaps?
You know, the only two girls on the show, really. I can't imagine we won't bond in real life, so I'm sure on the show. And, I'm curious to see about how this past life thing works for her character and how they're going to pull that in. It's like each character has so much going on, and there's so much to pull from. I'm glad I'm not writing the show. It'd be such a headache.
Which of the heroes on the new show would you want to see your kind of your character paired with to kind of work with? It doesn't seem like they're a cohesive team yet, but they could be soon.
Captain Cold and Heatwave. Just because I like them. but I think, like, with Heatwave's character, I see Sarah and him just like, boom, like, not getting along. I think that would be really fun and interesting to play with. And when we were shooting our promo trailer and with Wentworth's character, and I found, like, I was like, oh, like, his character and my character is like, are more like, they're on a line of kind of sarcastic whatever, go with it. So I think they would be fun to interact with.
Can you talk about the costume for White Canary versus your Black Canary costume, how it's different other than the color, of course?
And in this piece that we added.
And what you like about it or not?
I like this piece here. Though it's, I'm sure a lot of little boys are very disappointed about that audition. it's very similar. We kept a lot of, it was such a good costume, so we kind of kept that and just upgraded it a little bit. And I'm also working on getting, like, different jackets and kind of, I like the fact that I can take the jacket off and it works. So it's not just like one stiff action figure outfit. As you saw in the promo, I don't have a wig and I don't have a mask, which, like, logistically speaking, is amazing. I don't know if you guys have ever worn a wig and a mask for 16 hours, but it's not that comfortable. And I'm really excited to be able to, like, move my face and express emotion. So that'll be good. And for stunts, it's cool because I do a lot of my own stuff, and I do a lot of fighting. And when I have a wig and a mask on, you can't even tell if it's my double or if it's me. So it's kind of cool to do that. And it's very freeing. I dig the white costume for sure. It's a lot of fun.
What do you have in common with your character? Some quality?
I'm also an international assassin in real life. Enjoy playing them. I don't know why, but like one of the kind of most natural characters are these very, a lot of the indie films and things I've done are these very strong, like guarded women. And I think it's interesting. I mean, when it's, they don't show everything, you don't always know what's going on. But I, since the beginning with Sarah, I've always liked the fact that it's, she's just not a typical female character. I thought she was very interesting and, you know, with her sexual relationships, her strength, physical capabilities, and I don't know, she's not so, she's just interesting to me, she's so different, but I guess for me the connection is, I don't know, I guess she's badass, she fights, I fight in real life, so it's fun for me.
What reunion do you think would be the most difficult for her?
I think her father. Because, I mean, at this point, like, I would imagine he would, like, see her and be like, you know, I'm like, F you. You've died, like, 5 times on me. I'm tired of this, like, crying your back and then you leave again. I think that would be hard. Just for what she's put him through. So, yeah, Lance.
What do you think Sarah would think of Laurel taking up the mantle of Black Canary?
Not so into it, I would imagine. Because, I mean, look where it got her. She's dying. which Sarah has done a lot, it takes a piece of your soul, and enough to the point where Sarah feels like there's darkness, you know, like she's darkness, that she's lost that light.